Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today we're going to spend a little bit of time talking about Threadlockers, looking at the Permatex line in particular, also help you determine which Threadlocker is going to be best for your application. Now, if you go and do a little bit of research on these, it's almost overwhelming. I mean, the amount and the different types of Threadlockers that are available, it can be a little bit of a daunting task. And what you're going to find is that there's a lot more out there than just your typical blue and red Threadlocker. They make several different formulas that can address just about every single application that you're going to run into, no matter what you're working on. As a general rule of thumb, you cannot go wrong by using Threadlocker on just every single bolt on your machine. And there's a couple of advantages other than just holding the nut or bolt in place. But because this is an anaerobic type sealant, it actually forces air out and seals in the absence of air. And what that means is when you actually put it on the threads, it does not activate until it is actually put together. At that point, it forces out all the air and then cures. Now here's the other side effect of that. Well, guess what? If it's forced out all the air, then that's going to keep corrosion from actually working its way into the threads and freezing up that particular fastener. Now, if you're in the marine industry, that is invaluable because that is the harshest environment that I can think of. Salt water, it doesn't get much worse than that. Also, it makes it easier to assemble because it acts as a lubrication as you're putting it together. What I'm going to do now is just walk you through a flow chart where you can answer simple questions that will guide you to which product is going to fit best for your application. The first question you need to ask is, can you apply this before assembly? In some cases, you may have already had something that's put together that you want to make sure that it holds. They actually have a product that addresses this particular application. You actually put it at the top of the threads and it will wick down into the threads and then actually seal it up and hold it in place. Now, the majority of the thread lockers out there, they're designed to be applied before you actually assemble it. The next question we need to answer is the diameter of the thread that we're talking about. Is it a large diameter, you know, 1 inch or greater, or is it a smaller diameter? Now there is some overlap and there is no absolute here, but this is mainly just a guide to tell you which way to go. Now if it's a really small, fine thread, let's say anywhere from a quarter up to a half inch, even up to 3/4, then you want to look into the blue thread lockers. Your application for the blue thread locker would typically be for valve cover bolts, water pump bolts, oil pan bolts, rocker arm adjustment nuts, carburetor studs, shift lever, brake caliper parts, typically for bolts that you know you're going to have to hold in place, but there's a high probability that you're going to have to pull them out 3 or 4 times during the life of the vehicle. And we want to do that with the minimum amount of effort. You don't want to have to bring out a heat gun to actually break it down. Next, let's look at your applications for bolts that may go from 1/2 inch, 3/4 inch, and even larger, and they're going to be in a high strength application and or a high temperature. That is where you're going to want to use something in the red Threadlocker line. The red Threadlocker series, particularly, I love using the red on the inside of an engine. That way I know whatever nut or bolt that I've put in there, it's going to get held in place. Some of the applications are going to be cylinder block studs, rocker arm studs, ring gear bolts, frame bolts, shock absorber bolts, your transmission shaft bolts, camshaft sprocket bolts, your idler bearings. I mean, you name it. If it's inside of your engine, that's absolutely where you need to use the high temperature thread locker to make sure that those nuts and bolts and fasteners stay in place. That is going to be the most high stressed area on your machine. But let's be honest, are you going to keep 8 to 10 different thread lockers in your toolbox? Probably not. My rule of thumb for my toolbox, I at least have a blue and a red on hand because there is a lot of overlap, and just having those two in your box, that will get you through and get the project done for the day. Well, listen, if you need these or any other parts for your machine, why don't you come see us at Partzilla.com and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below, and I'll do my best to answer them. And hey, if you like what you see, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Partzilla, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.